you go through brings what's already in you out.
Okay. So what path or religion are you in your pursuit of perfection with God? what are you?
I was raised Seventh-day Adventist.
Okay. And what does that mean?
Seventh-day Adventist is a Christian denomination. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that we believe is observing the Sabbath. Mm-hmm. So from a young child, you know, being brought up, I was always brought up with Sabbath observance. So Friday night sundown, Saturday night sundown, as mentioned in the Ten Commandments, remember the seventh day to keep it holy. And then also Jesus observed Sabbath as well.
Yeah.
So it's one day where I don't check my emails. I don't respond to work calls. I don't read
from
any script.
Friday night sundown
to Saturday night sundown.
Yeah.
No work.
You don't check your emails.
No.
That's like against the commandment of Hollywood that thou shalt carry thy BlackBerry at all times.
But you know what? Here's a good thing. When you set boundaries.
Yeah.
Up front. Here's what my commitment is. So we all agree.
I love this,
Devon. Before we even take the job or go down the road.
Yeah.
Here's a commitment.
Yeah.
Are we all agreeing this is okay? Mm-hmm. So then all I have to do is just make sure I keep the commitment.
Yeah.
Because the moment I break it.
Yes.
Is the moment they realize, oh, well, he wasn't that serious. Mm-hmm. But for me, Sabbath is a time to recharge. It's a time to rest. It's a time to spend time with my family. It's a time to spiritually reconnect.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
What is interesting is that you allow your faith, your belief in God, to be at the forefront of who you are in a place where most of us, and you even say in the book, I remember when I said to my father, I was like 13, 14, Dad, I'm going to be an actress. No daughter of mine is going to be going out to Sodom and Gomorrah.
Oh, boy.
Sodom and Gomorrah.
You know the line.
Sodom and Gomorrah. Yeah, right. So you're living in what a lot of certainly traditional Christian people see Hollywood as the land of everything but following the path of your faith. How do you make it out there?
Well, you make it by being true to yourself. Mm-hmm. And
like literally for your first job. I'm sorry to interrupt.
Okay.
For your first job. Working as an intern with Will Smith, you say to them, look, I have to have the Sabbath off, which may I just confess that I learned in my first meeting with Devon, all these years I thought the Sabbath was Sunday. Yeah. I've been going to church. We say worship on the Sabbath, worship on the Sabbath in the Baptist church. And you corrected me. You said, no, Sunday is the first day of the week. Yeah. Sabbath is Friday sundown to Saturday sundown.
That's right. That's
right. I stand corrected.
Amen.
So you go to your first job with Will Smith and say, look, I'm really excited to be here, but I have to have
Friday night sundown, Saturday night sundown off. And what happened was it was.
Weren't you scared to say that?
Yeah, I was scared. It wasn't intentional.
Like it wasn't intentional.
It wasn't intentional, but I'm there in the interview.
Yes.
And God starts to literally, it feels like he's speaking to me. You know, because everything goes great. I feel like, okay, yeah, I got this in the bag. You know how you just go in and you land, it's all good. But at the end of the interview, it was like God was saying, tell her about the Sabbath. And I'm like, no, I'll tell her after I get the internship.
After
I get what I want.
I'll tell them.
Right. Yeah. But he said, no, be obedient. And so I said, man, all right, well, here's the thing. I can't take this internship if I have to work Friday night sundown or Saturday night sundown because I observe the Sabbath. And she was quiet. And then after a moment, she said, don't worry. Work around that. And I said, hallelujah. And what it did was it gave me confidence that if I embrace who I am, it will open doors, not shut them. Also,
that's really big. Hold that a moment. Pause. Tweet. Okay, good. Go ahead.
But also, thinking about doors, right?
Yeah.
If your faith won't fit in the door that opens, then I argue do not walk through that door. The door that God has opened
for
you. Will fit your faith.
That's such a tweet. I have to take a break. I have to take a break and tweet that myself.
All right.
Okay, we'll be right back.